got carbs. Yeah.
Got carbs, then turn it. Catabolizing the monomers, learn it. I gotta break it down before I burn it. I gotta break it down before I burn it. Got carbs, then turn it. Catabolizing the monomers, learn it. I gotta break it down before I burn it. Gotta break it down before I. You ate a carb? Let's focus on breaking it down. It's not that hard.
Phosphate, take it. Enzymatic aldolase will break it. How? Because the lysine residue at aldolase's active site forms an imine with fructose. Then aspartate acts as a base catalyst to make 2-3 carbon species. That's how. That's a good question. Now let's get back to the lesson.
Glyceraldehyde is then oxidized. Then you create bisphosphoglycerate. It's high in energy. Matter of fact, it's so high in energy, it recreates ATP. 3-phosphoglycerate uses histidine isomerase to 2-phosphoglycerate. Man, it's getting kinda late. Better do an E1CB reaction to make phosphonyl pyruvate. ATP is created one more time. Don't forget this happened on both sides. That means 4 ATP and 2 pyruvate. From 2 ATP and 1 glucose, I think that's pretty great. Don't forget about NADH. Needs to be oxidized back into NAD plus every day. If oxygen is present, you will be okay. And pyruvate is free to make acetyl-CoA. But if there's no oxygen, then pyruvate itself oxidizes NADH. This creates lactate. You can feel it in your muscles every time you exasperate.
Yeah. Got carbs, then turn it. Catabolizing them.